Okay, so we're going to go through how to solder up for a night flying using L-wire. So let's start with the kinds of L-wire that you have in the world. Sorry, it's a little noisy visually. But this is the finest stuff. This is the, I think it's 1.1 millimeter, 1.2 millimeter. L-wire is really fine. Looks really good. It's good for, you know, tight filigree work. The next size up is the 2.3 or the 2.5. I don't know which one this is. They're kind of indistinguishable. The 2.5 is a little brighter. You'll see it in the promotional materials, but this is the next size up. And then there's a bigger size beyond that even, which is this 5 millimeter L-wire, which is the same core as the 2.5, I think, but just with more plastic around it, so it has a little slightly bigger visual image. I've never used this in an airplane. It just looks kind of heavy. Someone gave this to me, but just want you to know it's out there. This is a data sheet from our L-wire provider. We use Coolite. Let's see, what is it? Coolite.com. These guys have pretty good stuff, and they've been pretty reasonable to us. The data sheet that comes with it. All the cool things you can do with L-wire. Okay. So the name of the game is we start with trying to wire up an inverter. And the inverter we use for RC is this, which is a it's a Coolite, let me just read it, IFW3294BL, and this is the inverter that we use. It's a, I think it's listed as a 3 to 5 volt, maybe. I can't remember what the range is, but this is the one you want. Yeah, come on, focus, there we go, inverter, and you want to, I'll say it again, it's the 3294BL inverter. That's the one we use. You'll notice this one has, so let's go through what's going on here. This is a connector that's going to connect to the some free channel on your receiver. This is a toroidal core. I don't know how you say, if that's how you say it, but this is meant to eliminate any feedback to the receiver of this AC generator and interfering with its operation. If you're flying 2.4 gigahertz, you don't need this. If you're flying with 72 megahertz, you probably do, because this is probably putting out some kind of hertz rate that's going to interfere. And then out the other end of this inverter are the leads, which is going to be an AC set of leads. This one's a little different. It has two separate connectors that are going to connect pieces of L-wire, and out the door they go. I'm going to do a different approach, but you get the basic idea. This runs from the receiver to the inverter. Coming in at 5 volts, and then all of a sudden it goes off to run, drive the L-wire. All right, so we start by making this up, which is going to require me to have the first tool that I don't have, which is, there we go, set of snippers. We're going to take off this little 9-volt thing. You know, why they ship this thing with a 9-volt connector on it when it really does not want 9 volts? You'd fry it if you connect it to 9 volts. I do not know. So I'm not going to bother doing anything except soldering this up. So we're just going to strip it really quick. Strip our wires. There we go. And then on this side, we're going to play the same game. I'm just going to clean that up. That looks a little bit kind of on the furry side. So I am just going to take a little bit off of both of them. All right.
Oops. Missed it.
And you can see my advanced stripping technique here is just basically I just kind of grab it a little bit and pull it off. Generally, a little insulation. Let's go. Okay, so we stripped them. Now we're going to tin them. So tinning up. It's going to work like this. Grab the supply of solder adulterated by children, and in we go with this. And then we got the other side. Just take care of these right here, right now. Okay, those two good enough. Okay. Now, the connector that we're going to do the connection to the receiver is I'm going to use a 0.10 inch headers. I've got these nice little prefabricated ones that fit receivers pretty well. So I'll just pick them up, just pick this up, sorry. And I'm going to tin it as well. And you can get these at places like DigiKey or MasterCard has them. I can't remember where I got these. Perhaps I'll put it on the website. Someone sends me a case of beer. So the important bit here is I know that I'm going to be running with a little heat shrink would be useful at this juncture. So we just take, I do make some noises about trying to keep short circuits from happening in my world. So we want to heat shrink things up. And so we'll slide these over. Sorry. Before I make up this joint, there we go. So both sides are tin, so they should come together really pretty quickly. The important bit is that the hot lead is in the center always and the ground is on the outside. So I'm just going to take that bad boy. Get it right. Come on. If you're not very good at soldering, there's a good trick, which is take a set of header pins, just slide them in when you're soldering, because it'll keep the plastic from, if the plastic gets all soft, it'll keep the alignment right. So I'll use that trick right now, and so we'll solder this one up. Yeah, screwed up. So that one fell off because I just touched it by mistake. Just hit it again. Okay, solid. And we have ourselves that made up. Slide these. Oops. Looks like the positive fell off. I don't care. You know, as long as I have one of them insulated, it'll be fine. Good enough for now. All right, and we can wrap it in some tape later, hit it with some hot melt glue. All right, let's do the other side now. So this is a little more complicated because what we're going to have to do is we're taking this double-headed pin here, and we're going to use it for connecting two sets of L wire. So the way this connects is this way. So I want the two slices of wire to go that way. It doesn't really matter. This will connect either way perfectly well. But I just try to do it to what the manufacturer kind of had some intention about. Tin this up. Let's see if I get that right. Come on, baby. Just trying to go fast. Battery's low on the camcorder. Okay. Now, this is the trick. So I'm going to run both of these two leads across two of these. Comme ça, if you can get it. Let's see if you can get a good view of that. So this is going to drive two of these. I'm going to heat from this side until they kind of look like they're all flowy and nice. And hold it. Owie, finger burning. Good, means I'm doing it right. And now I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. I have soldered so many of these, it drives me crazy. So I have tried to come up with a technique for doing these very quickly. That is, you know, generates a reliable solder joint. Yeah, come on, a little more. So, take a quick look at that. You see, I have two leads connected that way. Let me just visually inspect it closer to my eyes. I seem to have solid solder connections to everything. You know, I might fuss with that a little more, but you know, this is a video, so we're just trying to move the ball forward here. Clean it up a little bit, just because I don't want there to be big old lumps coming out. Although those lumps will be useful when I have to just guess orientation when I'm powering this thing up. Okay, so this is our inverter. It is now made up and ready to drive some L wire. So let's make up a piece of L wire. So I've got a piece of L wire here, and this is how it's going to end up. I'm going to strip it in such a way that you have an inner conductor and an outer conductor. The inner conductor exposed and two fine wires, and then some insulation and these little tiny things. And this is not going to come out real well in the photography, but I'm trying to talk you through it. So the most useful tool on the planet for doing L wire is this thing, and you can get these from Tower Hobbies for about, I don't know, 10 bucks or something. And it's a stripper, and it's not meant to strip L wire, but it strips L wire better than anything I've ever seen, and I've blown hours trying to figure out how to strip L wire by hand. So what I do is I hold it like about right here, and it's about, I don't know, 3/8 of an inch, almost a half of an inch in, you guess. You can see right where, how that is. See, there you go. And I'm just, you just press it cleanly. Now notice that we have a smaller, that just takes the outer layer out. And I take those jaws again, I apply them, and same game, just doink, without even thinking about it, sliding down. And the question is do I have two little fine aluminum wires down there that I can pull off? And it is, there's one, you can just barely see it on the screen, and there is maybe not another. Let's see, let me look with my eyeballs. Got one, no, we got them both. Yeah, I think we got them both. Yeah, yeah. Okay, there's two little wires that came up off of that, all right? And I made a mistake. I didn't go far enough, so we're going to do it again. Cinema Verite, folks. All right, so a little deeper in this time, just because I don't want to screw it up. There it is. It's maybe now at a half inch. Get that off, and then we're going to do it again, right up to where the cut was before, and hit it again. And we get one and... two wires, perfect. They come out, I don't know if you can see them. Two tiny little wires come out. They are very fragile, very, very fragile things. These are used to excite the phosphor core. It's on the inside and drives the illumination of the L wire. All right, so the next step is we need to expose some of, so this is, there's a phosphorus coating on this copper inside, and we're just gonna scrape it off gently. Do it any way you can. I use a knife sometimes, or these really nice bullnose cutters do a great job of it. Use your fingernails, whatever it takes. You just got to get that off. And there it is. You can see it's nice and, sorry, nice and exposed looking. All right. It's kind of constantly out of focus. I think it goes on a very macro lens. But all right. So this now is going to become the basis of our connection to the inverter. So... the way I do this is we get it in the helping hands. This is impossible without helping hands. I don't think it can be done without helping hands. And then we're going to take some header pins, male header pins, and I just snip them off, just a pair of them, and that's it. These are so weak that you can just hit them with your hand. You can snip them with your fingernails. Doesn't matter. So I'm going to take this side, and this is what I'm going to try and solder to, and they're going to hold... what I also like to do is the same trick I did on the other side, which is find a female set of header pins in case this plastic gets all hot when I'm messing with it, just to keep this thing, all this stuff aligned, because when they get out of line, then it's really kind of a bummer. So there it is. Those are the male header pins, at least the connection side of it. And then we're going to get these guys talking to each other through some solder. Okay. So we're going to now tin the ends of the males right here, or these little connector parts. Get them nice. You might get a blob of solder on there. It's kind of nice to do that because it. Can you see? Yeah. Sorry. I'll try to get that out of there. Okay. It's like I'm doing robot surgery here, or telesurgery. Okay. That looks pretty good. And then. I don't bother tinning the L wire at all. Job one is try to get this bad boy, the core of it, kind of connected, and I just sit there and I get it sort of holding there mechanically and lined up nicely. And what I like is for there to be a little bit of tension so that I don't have to use my fingers to make it all happen, but there we go. All right, now I'm going to heat this up until those guys seem to get all nice and happy together. And did that work? I don't know. No, it did not work. Let's go again. I'm going to hit it with a little solder this time. You may not be able to see this, but... yeah. You know, it's not the best joint ever, but I got them connected and they're pretty solid. And now that I've got the little tiny guys, they're off to the side, and I'm going to bring them around. What I find really useful when I'm trying to deal with the small ones is have a bamboo skewer or something very small and pointy to move them around. I forgot to acquire one of those. Where's my bamboo skewer supply? Well, you know, I don't have it, so it's going to work with what we got. Anyway, some small pointy thing to help you get these guys kind of wrapped around and doing the right thing and connected just mechanically and together on that second side. Okay. Yeah, that looks pretty good actually. Okay. And then we're just going to solder that untinned side. As soon as I find some available solder here. Okay. Let's see, did I get it? Yeah, and you kind of want to test it a little bit. Convince yourself that it's a good connection. Because it's... There we go. Wow, that's a big old blob. Okay, that's convincing. Got a big old blob of solder under there. Both of them are connected. You can see where the fine wires went and where those went. Now, you might be tempted to test it at this point. And I think you probably should, but I tend to not do that just because I have confidence in my soldering skills. And you also there's a tendency for them to actually break if you mess with them at this stage. So I'm just going to go through and assume I've got good joints everywhere, and they look pretty good. I'm inspecting them. They look pretty reasonable. Pull off this, and then I'm going to show you how we do the heat shrink step, which is absolutely key. This is what makes these joints fairly robust in the face of quite difficult conditions. So find yourself some heat shrink that's a little bigger than the joint that you're trying to do. You don't want to be hugely bigger, but just a little bit. And what you want to do, I'm just going to do this for display purposes, but take this out, and you want some hot melt glue. And that hot melt glue is going to, you're going to basically just take it, and I use the cheapest hot melt glue I can find. I get these from dollar stores. And you just sit there and just, sorry, you can't really see, can you? A big old blob of hot melt glue in there. There we go, isn't that nice? Keep it away across from the contacts. And then before it all gets too cold, you just want to slide that, generally I go the other way, but slide that heat shrink over it so that it is now sort of, so it's over that hot melt glue, and then you get the heat gun, which should be here someplace and plugged in. Where did I put it? Oh well, I don't have a heat gun. So we're going to do this the old school way, which is we're just going to hit this, we're going to heat shrink this stuff using the soldering iron, which is my usual cheat. I'm in a tight spot. And it's good to learn to do it this way, because when you start doing field repairs, you're not going to have a heat gun with you. But you might need to make up some hail wire in the, you know, in the desert in a windstorm. And these skills will serve you freaking well. Okay, so we have the inverter that we made up. This will support two connections. This connection here, I tend to wrap in heat shrink and hit with hot melt glue and make really strong. But you can figure that out. I've shown you the basic idea of how that goes. And so I'm going to connect this up to here, and let's see if we can't get these guys to fire up. Oh, it'd be nice if I brought out my spare 4.8 volt battery pack. Let's see if I can dig it up real quick. Ah, there it is. Good. This is super useful. Just have yourself just a NiCad pack. You might have one laying around or something that's just the right voltage for doing this kind of stuff. The way this would usually work is this would connect to the DC inputs, but I'm just going to test right now. I'll show you that in a second. My headers. Okay. So I just take these header pins, line them up like this. And then we make sure the voltage, these are lined up correctly, negative, negative, positive, positive, and There we go. We have lit L wire. Isn't that nice? And we just made that up. And you should not run these inverters without a without a load on it, without L wire connected to it, or they'll fry. So just be sensitive to that. If you touch this at all, it'll shock you a little bit. There's a lot of AC voltage out. It'll really quack you a little bit. So that's it. So that's how you do it. When you put this on an airplane, it's going to be like the following. Let's go find an airplane that we can connect it to. Let's see. How about we walk over here? Let's do our Make Magazine Build airplane. Ah, yes. You're a good example. So the way this is going to connect to an airframe is you essentially do not put it on your soldering iron, but so this would connect to any spare channel on this receiver with the proper orientation with ground to the back, generally for these kinds of receivers, but check the manual. And then when we power this thing up, it should power up the L wire too. So here's the L wire that we just made up, and there it is. And attach it, there we go. It's powered up and lit. So this whole rig now is running off of the DC power bus on the towel. Okay, so the way we fly these is usually we put 5 feet of L wire on each of these two slots here. And we do something different colors for top and bottom, and just do something creative so you can see what this thing looks like at night. Here's some airplanes that are a little more advanced, but very pretty, I think. And so here's a jellyfish that we do, and you can see that right there. Look at all that nice L wire. Here, I'll even turn off the lights a little bit so you can see this better. This thing looks awesome at night. And you can just sort of see how much this punches. You don't see it so much during the day, but at night it really has an effect. And then let's see if we can't get the let's see if I can do this in the dark. So we also have the bat. Let's see if we can't get the bat going. And it says. There we go. So the bat. So this is kind of the bat. And this bat is really something. I don't know if you can get the whole thing there. Let me see. I don't even have a place big enough to put it. Well, I can just put it right here. All right. Something like that. There. So that is the bat. And it's in its glory. You know, there's a little bits of interference because there's parts of covering that are covering the parts of the battery. The tape's a little dirty, but that thing looks awesome at night. Just sort of flies around in a very sort of classy way. Here's what it looks like. Another view. The really cool tail. All right, well, that's it. That's how you make up L wire. That's the basics. Enjoy yourselves and send us a picture.